we're saying? We're going to have a good night. This is our second homecoming of the last 2 months. It's good to be back. What constitutes a ghetto? Huh? Is it growing your own lettuces in the potholes on the road? Do the locals have to eat them all if they don't sell them? Actual potholes, concrete meadows of the soul. What constitutes a ghetto fetish? Is it growing your own lettuces but not filling in the potholes? The local council will be getting an earful, believe me. Call their lug holes, concrete bollards to the soul. We all make the same sound when we get mowed down. And there are starving children in Africa, so go send your toy guns to Bosnia. All offers are final, then how is it even possible for it to be both flush and completely principled? I hear, well, I did not do it for you. I did it for the little boys and girls, pulling lettuce from the potholes, posing up the edge of those wax, wax, wax apples at Christmas. Next year they're all sniffing glue. Oh, sometimes blinded by powerful lying. Tomorrow's world's got in store for me. Your freedom don't come cheap. I'm battling hard with no room to give. Living my life as if I had it a complete sim. Hold your horses, man, there's up his foot in knees. My pain's been exhausted since I did grieve. But from the causeway, it's hard to see the full extent of the damage. You couldn't see the woods and the trees. Fuck me, how am I supposed to cope? The age of the gents cried savage. It's no hope! Kids these days think they've been outdone by. Never even looked into that long like God it was. They got the whole thing wrong, just bumbling along. On the bottom front, knocking boots and hooking the side of bombs. What you've got is a constant hit. Constant hit! Stop! Well, for your pain, my day, the gear on the street was so weak. Could eat your ambition in a matter of weeks. Just trying to envision the peak, and that's bleak. Leads. That's bleak! The overload, a discontent, the constant burden of making sense. It won't relent, it won't repent, as you remain in dissonance. The overload, a discontent, the constant burden of making sense. It won't relent, it won't repent, as you remain in dissonance. Oh, oh, oh no. Get what you need to understand. standards. If you want to make some decent money from it, you'd be better off kicking that liquor singer you got in out the band. Forget yourself and dig down the ground. And oh, I'm not fat Andy, I'm the baby up. For giving you a leg up and you just give my hand. Just don't be doing originals. Play the standards and don't get political. I know I love liquor singers, right? You let them in the back of the ambulance with the mic stand round the exhaust house overall, because you couldn't ignore the flag and be polite, sir. Show some respect, listen to my advice, because if you don't challenge me on anything, you'll find I'm actually very nice. Leeds, are you listening? Come on!
The overload of discotheques, the constant burden of major sets. It won't relent, it won't repent, how to remain in dissonance. The overload of discotheques, the constant burden of major sets. It won't relent, it won't repent, how to remain in dissonance.
The overload of discontent, the constant burden of broken sense. It won't relent, it won't repent, how to remain, how to remain in dissonance, how to remain in dissonance, how to remain in dissonance, how to remain.
Can I pay some? Cheers, man.
Is everyone all right? Outside, nearly broke my neck. It's all connected in a certain respect. My neck in the stack, the conversation.
Can I get a witness? Can I get a witness? Can I get a witness? Can I get a witness?
Well, you're falling, son. Swallow your pride, I'm at war with the Lord, but the Lord is on my side. The early jungle in the Amazon's prime. It's not technically a crime.
Can I get a witness? 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 Oh, can I get a witness?
Well, that depends.
Can I get a witness?
You're gonna trust your friends.
Can I get a witness?
Cheers. This is our 9th gig in 10 days. We've been run fucking ragged, my voice is on the fritz. I'm giving it everything I have for you because we're where? Leeds, right? And where are you at from by default, even though none of us are from here? Leeds, yeah. Yeah, true. That's not what that line means, though, but it does work, yeah. Duality. Yeah, this show sold out a long time ago. Who's been here from pretty much day one? Yeah? Old school. The old school fuckers. This one's for you. What a day to be alive. The state of everything. I know you saw the sign in the window. The brain fist on hollow wood. Sticky fingers on sugar glass. Are you really all so desperate? Desperate, desperate. All that divides us is evil. All that unites us is evil. All that really divides us is the battery hotline. And the restraint that it takes not to stick ourselves into every abstract object on the good gallery shelves. When the chapter came around, he was trying to sell me pelts. It was midday on a Monday, so all the smart people were at work. Jab music blaring from his 30 boom box. The temperature turned on left as he flipped. He said, shut your fucking trap. All eradicate nature, right now forever. Well, I'll eradicate nature, right now forever. So I bought all his pelts, all of his pelts, at a bullfire disco. Woo! Took out a small business loan and I bought all his pelts. I threw them in the boot of my car and drove downtown. I pitched up a store outside the office blocks. And come 5 o'clock, well, it was so cold that everybody wanted one, everybody needed two. So I upped the price and I bled and drank. That's what you do. Come 6 o'clock, wow, I'd oversold, and my smile was made a solid cold. Under the waves of my own success, are you with us? Are you with us? At the back, are you fucking with us? Yes. Driving away with my many grapes, my many women, and my ginormous mountain of never-ending blow. I saw the trapper disappear from my rearview mirror with no belts to call his own. Shivering, naked, and solitary in the snow. Senseless child, the Nordic guilt. Trapper's pelt, trapper's pelt. Senseless child, the Nordic guilt. Trapper's pelt, trapper's pelt. Senseless child, the Nordic guilt. Trapper's pelt, trapper's pelt. Senseless child, the Nordic guilt. Trapper's pelt, the trapper's pelt. HMRC, pay us your fear. Has always felt like a second home to us, and it's good to have two homes, isn't it? It's a second home. This is the front door to my second home. Thanks for being here in my living room. Someone's at the door. Shall we see who it is? It might be the Avon lady or the
the man who gets the £2.50 a week for the Little Woods catalogue. Your mum makes you draw the curtains and pretend you're not in when they come. Oh, the bloody window cleaner. We always dodged the window cleaner and I always felt bad about it. I saw the car that they drove. They're getting frustrated. I'm going to go see who it is. Sorry, there's a porch as well, so... Hey, mate. Hiya. Do I know you? Yeah, I live across the road. Oh, right. Have you just moved in? Yeah, I have. Oh, right. What do you want? Well, I've just been delivered this parcel, and it's not for me. Oh, right. It's not for me either. All right. Do you want to come into my house? And I'll wait out here and you can come and have a look at my living room. Yeah, all right then, yeah. Yeah, let's see how good it is compared to mine. All right, Jay, I'm ready now. Hello there, I got a letter in the post addressed to the previous owner. I don't know how you pronounce their name. I don't think that they were from round here, you know. Well, I just moved into the area. Yeah, that big old thing over the road. It's a fixer-upper, though. It's a fixer-upper, so we're gonna put pounds up till I've got some frogs everywhere. That's all the power, very nice round you could gutter. Got a Prosecco o'clock poster, half price in IKEA. And it goes nicely with the existential fear that I feel when I accidentally stop and wonder what the fuck I'm doing here and how long I got left before I'm 6 feet under. I can't believe I'm a 2-0 owner. Finally, I'm a 2-0 owner, but the driveway's lease from Cotswold Stone and it's off-street parking for your Rover. It's a fixer-upper though, yeah, not the Rover. The Rover's fucking golden. I'm talking about that big old thing over the road, yeah. That big old thing over the road. We're gonna knock through your kitchen wall though. Great to listed Edwardian architecture. We're gonna absolutely ruin it all around. We can't stand old shit. It's a fixer-upper, woo! It's a fixer-upper, every time. Fixer-upper, ah! It's a fixer-upper. Anyway, this letter I'll just post it back, return to sender, unless you think you know him. Think he goes by the name Mr. J. Connor Pinsky. I'm not that smart, I'm not that sedate. Did the Dr. J. Connor Pinsky, do you know him? Sounds a bit Russian to me. Polish acid, and he had a PhD, did he? Well, what in? The point of speed, your degree's not for me. Now, university of life, you see, I've got a big skin. School of hard knocks gonna knock through that wall on Tuesday, case you and a wife were gonna be. It's a fixer upper, woo! It's a fixer upper, every time it's a fixer upper. It's a fixer-upper! Alright mate, sorry about the commotion the other day. The bloody builders are refusing to finish the job until I pay them. I told them no one pulls a fast one on Graham. Yeah right. I'm Graham by the way, don't know if I mentioned. Told them I'm not made of money, having a laugh. Two homes in a Rover comes to my graph. I'm not minted, I earned it. Is this a funny voodoo business? I didn't walk on the other spurs to make the dent I did in under a year. I earned it in case you're wondering. The builders hook the Polish. I'm not bothered about that life, but where you come from says a lot about a man, and I might not be from round here, but I am. Also, they won't take cash in hand. What's for that? Maybe they wouldn't need the money so bloody bad if they weren't willing to give it all to the tax man. This ain't what you can get where I'm from. I'm not from round here, but I am. Scene. It's me again. Cheers. James. I get confused sometimes. He lives within me and he possesses me. When you have to be that man every night, you start to lose sense of who you really are. But what are any of us? None of us really know, do we? Cosmic slop fannying about, yeah. Peanuts in the ether. Here I am again. Here I am sitting in your waiting room, waiting for an appointment I had booked 6 months ago. I'm feeling real low, yeah. I was shitting bricks at the prospect of existence without you, and so I gave it one more go. But my story didn't stop, and suddenly it quit. Some allergies you tolerate, some habits you just have to kick. Ooh. I saw you on your back amongst the peanut shells all scattered on the floor of the big top, right next to the overwhelming sense of impending doom. Yeah, well, no one ever asked or mentioned anything to me about the elephant in the room, when suddenly it hit. Some allergies you tolerate, some habits you, yeah, you gotta bite the bullet, get it fixed, get it seated, slowly sticks. You gotta bite the bullet and get it fixed, get it seated, slowly sticks, slowly sticks, slowly sticks, slowly sticks. Ah! Cool. We've been running a competition on this tour. Does anyone want to do it? Who wants to partake? Who knows? Do you know all the words? Come on up here. Yup, he's up.
Oh, hey man, how's it going?
Do you want to do it all?
I'm Ben, I'm from Bradford.
Yes, Ben! Give Ben...
Here's a word in Edgeways. You always said that you'd met and fell in love with the circus. That's why you loved animals so much. So much so that you bought a big dog with little ears and named it Dumbo, which was a joke that got less and less funny every time. And of course you brought the dog along that night when you showed up otherwise alone to my dinner party. Having rung ahead to make sure all my dishes have been prepared in a completely nut-free environment. Now quipping that it was for the sake of your imaginary husband, because several years on from the wedding none of us were invited to, we still hadn't met him, even though he always said he was coming, before suddenly he couldn't make it because he worked away a lot with work. But mostly because he didn't really exist. You broke down in tears in my kitchen, certain he was seeing somebody else. How reckless we'd all been to tolerate your fabricated reality. But until now, I hadn't had the guts to put an end to the ever-maddening scenes. So with a solemn nod and totemic silence, I walked over to the cupboard where I kept the snacks. Took a pinch of dry roasted dust from the loose peg bag. sprinkled it in the trembling palms of your upturned hands and said, "If you just rub some of this around the rim of his can, no one will know, but we'll all understand."
Well, good.
It takes real guts to break things, and it takes real nuts to break fake guts.
Ben from Bradford. Bite the bullet and get it fixed. Get it seated. Starry sticks. Starry sticks. You gotta have a bite the bullet and get it fixed. Get it seated. Starry sticks. Starry sticks. Cause when starries do not stick, it means someone's about to twig. Your alibis must cooperate, or they will be fed to the fucking pigs. We warmed up now, Liz. I've sensed a shift in the energy in the room. This is the first time I've taken my coat off on this tour. What are you doing to me? The truth was sold, that's where the trail goes cold. My shoulders shudder at the fall, puffing my chest out as I walk home alone. Under the arches there's a bloke
with a car boot full of stolen phones, knock off the load and make carcasses.
Near me condition from selfishness, mate.
I see arsonists with business rates etched on the back of empty matchboxes and police officers getting the truncheons polished off in the bushes, wondering what all the fuss is about and what the fuck I'm looking at.
Dark days.
If looks could kill, my vacant gaze wouldn't even pierce the skin. I'm not lazy, ambition's something I've no interest in. At least when I meet my maker, I'll embrace all my mistakes. As I descend to the bowels of hell, the shit-eating grin on my face.
Dark days.
It's a never-ending cycle of abuse.
Dark days.
I have the blues and I can't shake them loose.
Dark days.
I have the blues and I can't shake the blues.
Dark days.
It's a never-ending cycle of abuse. I am, well, I was skeptic due to how the media have depicted you. Don't get to know you better. We clicked until we stuck together. Turning the corner of the burning cenotaph, and those coppers cut us. Stopped us, shook us up and down with no grounds to a no due process. Started discussing whether to let us off and doing nothing, or maybe cook us for looking like we might be hiding something. Then the radio buzzed in. Thank fuck I bought you enough time not to get whacked.
Dark days.
It's a never-ending cycle of abuse.
Dark days.
I have the blues and I can't shake them loose.
Dark days.
I have the blues and I can't shake them loose.
Dark days.
It's a never-ending cycle of abuse.
Dark days.
It's a never-ending cycle of abuse.
Dark days.
I have the blues.
Dark days.
I have the blues. I can't shake them loose.
Dark days.
It's a never-ending cycle of abuse. They're hard to swallow, who? I'm an acquired taste, didn't get. Gonna climb the ladder of success on Judgment Day. Take my advice and reinvent the real completely.
Dark days.
Believe me.
Dark days. Dark days. Dark days.
Again, again, again. Thank you. And he knew it early on, so his confidence kept growing. By 13 he had been with every girl deemed worth it to be with in the village. 2 years either side of his birthday, he played football. Boy could he play, played every single day, and he still does. A scout from Crew Alexandra came to watch him once and said that they were going to be in touch. Ever asking to be and without ever being told, that counts for a lot still, believe it or not. Lo and behold, everyone fell behind. The hair on his legs and the hair on his lips. He was the he could smoke 10 a day and still run faster than that whip in the good lap, the racetrack rabbit. He could dabble in the snow, rubbing shoulders with the rabble, and still never ever touch a pot of hobby. At age 16, he made his choice to stay and got a job selling houses in the village, which by now becomes such a desirable place to settle down. It was classed not as a village, but instead as a tiny town. the sunny, sunny side of your borough, you get two brown bins.
Fortunately, despite the influx of newcomers, including for the first time a genuine and authentic Italian restaurant run by a family of fantastic old school Neapolitans, he was still the best at football and a very handsome man. And he took solace in that fact as his tiny world continued to expand. To be within the village 5 years either side of his birthday, but it was time to settle down, and no kiss had ever felt so electric as the first he felt all those years ago, though she had never strayed far, hemmed in by a shadow. The torches light in the paths of her own dreams, and being growing dimmer by the day, and so faster than a dying star, she cashed in her chips, checked up and subsequently threw all of her own ambitions away, all of them away. Promotion followed. Mortgage. Marriage. A dog. Two dogs. One kid. Two cars. Two kids. A dead dog. And a second home on the Costa del Sol, and a loft conversion, and a conservatory, in the halls of Snowdon, the poles of two long lost souls. What comes first, counselling or keys in the bowl? He got paid redundant twice, but never once was he on the goal. And he put his own mother in this. He put his own mother. He put his own mother in a home. In a home. His own mother banished her. Light head, black spots on his vision, room spinning. Clutching at the curb, grimacing, they thought he was grinning, begging them to notice him, notice no one helping him, as the grandkids are waving, and the big, big electric gate draws a line in between them. There's a fine, fine line between benign and malignant, so get yourself checked, get yourself an appointment, sir. Get yourself checked, get yourself an appointment, sir. Get yourself checked to get yourself. Village and most of the town came out to mourn his end, to pay tribute to a once handsome man and a good friend. His whole family was so proud, knowing no one said a bad word about it aloud. He wasn't perfect, but he was my friend. He wasn't perfect, but he was one of us. He was one of us. One of us. And a plaque bears his name by a bench by the water's edge. The dates he came and went, and a quote about life and death from a song he'd never heard. As he wasn't too fond of long songs with lots of words. Yeah, if I were him, no, I'd have never left that village either. For I did, and I know full well, there are better footballers out there in Greater Manchester. They would have cut him down to size if they could have, but what good would that do? He bloomed and grew, and still he was doomed. Same as me, same as you, same as everyone I ever knew. You. Sometimes still I think about you, out there somewhere, floating in the ether. Born died in a wool, never knowing of a belly half full. So many of us just crabs in a barrel with no feasible means to escape the inevitable pull. There are those that grow thick skins quick for the sake of their sins, and the savvy folk who just know to take it all on the chin and keep their mouths shut. Because we lie to each other, don't we? And then we submit, and then we bare our teeth, and then we catch fish using giant metal ships, and we stagger home pissed at 4 a.m. down moonlit country lanes, howling into the gutters, staring at the distant fields, wondering what lies beyond. And we cry because children are dying across the sea, whilst we benefit from the bombs dropped which we had no part in building, whilst madmen roam free, doing what they please. And we're so sorry. We were born sorry, and we feel it. We feel it every fucking day. But we're just trying to get by too. We're sorry. We're so sorry. We're sorry, truly, we're sorry. We're just trying to get by too. We're sorry. We're so fucking sorry. We're just trying to get by too. Thank you, Leeds. It's not all doom and gloom though, is it? Right now's all right. Isn't it? Is everyone all right? Are you? Are you sure? You don't sound so sure. Have we not done our job correctly? Are you going to demand a refund because we didn't fulfill your happiness quota for the day? That's a fucking hell. Let's end on a high note. This song is called Pour Another for everyone in this room. Thank you so much for being here. Cheers. It was a reasonable take, but in the time that it took to find a beat in the break, the needle combing through the grooves of your mind had already stuck. And so you turned to a friend, you asked them what they had left. They stuck their hand down the back of their pants and said, I think the conversation might be reaching an end. I said, we can't have that. Pour another for my brother, sister, or whichever other you prefer, we call you. Yeah, there's no judgment, only understanding while we're standing round and around watching the world burn. I saw the narrative peak, though it was not evident, as we agreed everything was so bleak, that giving your 2 pence on anything wasn't worth a single thing. So we have become friends, though I do not know your names. But come the morning, following the night that everything changed, I was ashamed to recognize everything had stayed the same. come on, Leeds, come on, Leeds, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on.
I said we can't have that. Crying over for our brother, sister, or whichever, oh, but you prefer it quiet. There's no judgment, only understanding while we're standing round and behind, watching the world burn.
Well, 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 Leeds. Right, to welcome our friend Chris Duffin to the stage. Give it up for Chris, come on! We're gonna exercise our No Wave credentials to the max. Say that to a sax player.
That's well predictable, that.
Almost by accident, I have become rich. Through continued reward for skilled labour in the private sector and the genuine lack of interest in expensive things, it appears I have become rich. And since I have become rich, I've been constantly living in fear of losing everything, that the bubble will pop and falling from my perch, I will return once again to the life that I used to lead with the things I didn't have before I had become what? Rich.
Rich.
It appears I have become rich.
Rich.
Rich. I put a pinch away each week in a place my hand wouldn't fit. It is made of solid steel, a square foot deep with a slit. No bigger than an inch.
Nah.
No bigger than an inch. Well, one day when the seam splits in such a way that it cannot be restitched, I'm gonna scratch that insatiable itch and buy the whole hospital and everything in it. Why? Because I'm... It appears I have become rich. You twitching like some headless bird, whilst the witch doctors poach for the stragglers in the hood, pitching for business down on Skid Row. The line goes out the door and you're right at the back. Man, two more poor dead kids in a ditch. Fucking love being rich. It appears I have become so rich.
So rich.
It appears I have become so, so rich. I'm literally drowning in it. But no matter how little I've got, I'll never lose the plot. On top of the hill, looking out over the valley, you can see for miles and still get shot. The farmer doesn't want his cows getting what the other cows have got. He keeps his livestock stuffed in his sock, and that's why he's rich.
It appears we've both become rich. It appears we're both very, very, very rich. It appears we both got gout, mate. It appears we have no shame. It appears I have become rich. Ooh, ooh, ooh. It appears I have become rich. No!
Forgive me, have mercy on my soul, never. No one ever tells you how tough it really is. Please teach me how to be modest and how to be rich in equal measure. I've done some terrible things because I'm rich. Looking for opportunities, invented this deposit ring, the silver ring. Joys are must be crushed, but then again, in a push, life is a bitch. I've become so rich, and people hate you for it. People really hate you for it.
It appears I have become rich. Oh. It appears I have become rich. It appears I have become rich. It appears I have become rich.
Cheers, Leeds. Do you want another one?
Yeah! Yeah. Woo!
Bastion of hope, this once great nation I'd left was its humour. So be it through continued mockery, this crap pot country are full of cunts. We'll finally have the last laugh when dragged underwater by the weight of the tumour it bombed. When it fell for the fear-mongering of the National Front's new hairdo. Yeah. So then what becomes of the inhabitants of this once unstoppable isle, when all of its exports are no longer in style? Are you seriously still trying to kid me that some culture's gonna be fine, when all that's left is Nomads Morris dancing to Sham 69? Gobble the red man and rally around the maypole, hijack your sound, stick a claim to it. Every campaign is statement made, always a new scapegoat to blame for it. Even my heart bleeds. You abandoned me, and I abandoned you too. Well, we both know I was the one like too, and I'm not scared of people who don't look like they're like you. Unlike you. Unlike you. Ah, well.
So
Soap Box
is an insidious, cease to find by its own stupidity. It's not real as it's already sentenced itself and played into death.
Soap Box
is an insidious, cease to find by its own stupidity. It's not real as it's already sentenced itself and played into death. The last bastion of hope, this one's great nation, unless it's good music. But we didn't nurture it, instead choosing to ignore it. Yeah, we've been trapped by the same crowd who don't like it unless they've heard it before. Leaving me stuck, flogging my progressive dead horse. South of the border to the post-so-sos. Free, free, freeze, this and that's buttered bread. Proud of it, whose values flit whenever it fucking suits them. And we're supposed to let it slide because the press has normalised the idea that racism is something we should humour. When the last bastion of hope, this one straight nation I've left, was to converse in a manner that'll pacify, divide and unite the room. Well, no one's talking. Irrational thoughts been forced into submission by the media through which all of our information is now concealed. Fake news leads. Are you out there? Hello, hello. Are you with us? Come on!
Soap Box!
It's an insidious, cease of our bias, of stupidity. It's not there, it's already set, cease of self-making to death.
Soap Box!
It's an insidious, cease of our bias, of stupidity. It's not there, it's already set, cease of self-making to death.
Soap Box! It's an insidious, cease of our bias, of stupidity.
One more for you if you want it. It's a limited edition, very rare, exclusive encore. It is. We're going to welcome Baba and Nick back to the stage. Oh, where are they? Nick. Baba Ali. Where's Baba? Are you coming on, man? Baba! Give it up for Baba! Leads, isn't it? So you got to do something special. It's been an absolute pleasure having Baba and Nick along for this tour. We've just had a fucking wicked time, made friends for life. Their album is incredible.
As is their new single, available on NFC if you fancy buying it from the merch stand.
And, yeah. Yard Act is playing at Nafe's house.
I saw you the road.
gotta set them up. Set them up.
Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on.
You gotta set them up. Oh, oh yeah. You gotta set them up. Oh, oh yeah. You gotta set them up.
Oh yeah.
Set them up. Well, Daft Punk is playing at my house. I waited 7 years and 15 days. Well, there's a freak out brewing at my house, my house. And the neighbors can't call the police. Well, Daft Punk is playing at my house, my house.
Woo!
And nobody could get in the door. Well, Daft Punk is playing in my house, my house. You gotta set them up, set them up. You gotta set them up, oh yeah. You gotta set them up,
oh yeah.
You gotta set them up.
Good evening.